Hey, this is Blacklight here. Well, what we're going to talk about today is we're going to touch on a little bit about Doctor Strange, what that whole movie is pertaining to. We're going to sum it up. And you notice they spoke a lot about time travel. So right now, they're in this present day, 2017, everybody locked up into the history. Now, Elijah Muhammad came to give us a thorough knowledge of self, our enemy, and introduce us to the God that's in us. Marcus Garvey came to organize us and to give us a sense of pride and love for the motherland, Africa. Noble Drew Ali was touching on a little bit of we could say it like this: the Moors when they were in their heyday in the conquering of Europe and using that science over here in America, Clarence X, he was about the street soldiers, the brothers in the street, giving them, they would never enter organized religion, but he was about giving them the knowledge of self, the enemy, et cetera, et cetera. Each of them had their roles to play, such as those of today, Mr. Farrakhan, or, you know, all those that are teaching, the way I see it, got a role to play. They all are parts of a puzzle, you know, and they all, whether or not they know it or not, we all are doing the will of the Most High. Because we all don't have all the answers, or we all don't interpret it the same way, but basically we're saying the same thing. But it's more so got to do with your deeds now. Not just talking, but walking it. You know, your deeds, how you manifest your God qualities. And the Caucasian is about still feeding off of us, but his time is running out. And he realizes this. So he's joining on to us, hoping that he could mingle in our flesh or integrate our flesh, but keep his same mind of him being the supreme being. And so we're going to show you why he's not the supreme being. It don't have nothing to do with color, because he's it do have something to do with color, because he lacks certain melanin components, certain carbon components, sulfur. He's a sulfur-based individual. And he knows this, you know. So what we're going to do is make this series, or this session, these sessions, I'm going to give you three sessions, short and sweet, because I'm going to start talking directly to him. But you can listen in, you know, my melanated brothers and sisters, y'all can listen in. Look, man, you know, I don't have nothing against you, but you don't have no authority. Your laws of this land, the whole concept you stole from the Moors and the Native Americans, sustained you by teaching you how to survive over here. We did this all over the world. Before you went to the caves of East Europe and after you came out the caves, and you're like a person who don't want to be led by the black man, because you know that your time is up. So the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad didn't want you to mingle in or to breed with us because of your mindset. And you got a whole lot of brothers walking around right now, what I call brothers, but they got the Caucasians mindset without even y'all breeding into us. So when you breed into us, when you send your woman out after us, and we merge in with your woman and have babies, technically that are black, but the mind is that of a Caucasian. This is your quest because it's one way for you to keep in control, you know. So we're going to finish up on this, so I want to advise my viewers and listeners to, you know, understand what I'm saying and stay tuned for part two, Black Light Out.